Welcome back to Monmouth. The battery has just been changed. We're starting with a par 3 down here. I think this is a course that you've got to play a few times and learn it before you can approach to playing your handicap. But I think there's some par 5s on the back 9, none on the front. So time for some revenge, don't you think? Number 10 is another blind tee shot. I can barely see the top of the flag. I've actually got to hit this over the corner, over these trees. I wonder what this is like from the competition tee. It must be incredibly difficult. Glad I'm playing forward. Slight shake of the head there because I had no idea where it finished, but it's made its way down onto the green. Do you know, I'm still not used to being able to repair stuff on greens. Feels a bit strange. Yeah, a bit shy. Bloody time. Well, this reminds me of the second shot, the 12th at Lilybrook. Steep upslope, 3 wood. And I really struggled to get through that. That was horrid. Caused by the slope. I still got 63, so you can see how short that 3 wood went. Yep, on the dance floor. But it's come off again. There's this little ridge, as if this hole needed any more difficulty. Now, if you're chipping these, always go nice and safe to the safe side. Get the easy part as opposed to trying to get the difficult bird. Another blind shot. Now, there is a marker in the middle of the fairway here, and with the wind off the right, I am going well right. And I think I've overdone it. It doesn't appear to have come back on the wind. And it hasn't. I'm in the rough here. Easy par though. Just a pitching wedge. Not sure what I've done here, but I've gone a mile right and the ground has taken it even further to the right. I'm in trouble. I'm going to land this short and bounce it up. That's one of my one of the shots in my skill set, is to land it short, bounce it up. The rest of this is a bit of a mess.
Oh shit. I'm rushing it now.
in a normal situation, I'd walk forward and have a really good look at this. But I got a fast two ball coming up behind me, so I'm going to start rushing. I rushed on that par three and made a bit of a pig's ear of it. And I've definitely made a pig's ear of that. That was just the putter. There was no way of stopping this ball anywhere near the flag. And if you've ever wanted an extra inch, yeah, I could have used it there. 16, another par 3. So I'm aiming a little bit right. The idea here is to land short and bounce it onto this tiny, tiny green. And it's just absolutely flown. I don't know whether I've pured it or whether the wind's behind, but that has gone miles. In fact, I got a full 30 yards coming back. But again, this bouncing the ball onto a green is part of my skill set. I mean, look at the width of this green. What is it? Is it 10 yards tops? 9 yards wide? Oh man, I don't believe it. Right, the last par 5, and it's a short one, and it's downhill. Let's give it large. And that is really, really a good drive. Another blind shot. Do you know, I think I've done all right considering I've never been here before. Couple of cock-ups on the par threes. Those greens up on top of the hill there, they seem to be more exposed and a bit faster. And when you look at the size of these greens, they're just tiny. So yeah, hard track. Oh bugger, I've hit that one too far as well. Never mind. Anyway, got two or three other courses to play in Monmouthshire yet, so it'll be a little while before I choose a favourite to go back to. Cheerio! I've got out of bounds all the way down the left as signified by that hedge, so the idea is I aim at it and then I slice it, or rather peel it away from it.
It's gone right a bit.
That's how I deal with out of bounds, really. Last shot up the hill, back into the breeze. A little bit skanky, I'm afraid, but it's straight.